I'm Davida Davini, and today we are going to explore the tropical islands of Asia in the Philippines. Located in Southeast Asia in the Western Pacific Ocean is the sovereign country of the Philippines, containing over 7,000 islands. Manila is the country's capital city. From here we travel by plane 200 miles south to reach the small paradise island of Boracay. We land at Calibo Airport in Panay Island and embark by transport bus to the jetty port of Catacalan, where a ferry boat brings us to our final destination. Our exploration begins at the southwest end of the island. Here beyond the beach rocks lies a coral shelf that contains countless varieties of living coral exposed above the water at low tides. To reach a closer view of the live coral beds, we make our way along the beach past the huge volcanic boulders and through shallow water. With the natural land and sea formation, this area is ideal for photography enthusiasts to capture breathtaking photos during the day and at sunset. Walking north along the coastline, we will explore the largest and most popular beach on Boracay. This is also where most of the hotels, restaurants, shops, and nightlife are situated in. It's the area containing the greatest amount of tourist and pedestrian traffic around the clock.
For sun worshippers, the powdery soft white sands of White Beach stretches 4 kilometers and is the most famous and popular beach on Boracay Island.
White Beach inherited its name from the soft white powder sand separating the land from the clear glassy water. Water temperature ranges from 78 to 85 degrees Fahrenheit throughout the year, providing a favorable environment for water sports swimmers and scuba divers. A tropical climate with temperatures that range from 73 degrees in January and reach over 90 degrees Fahrenheit sometime in May. Most of the rainfall occurs from May through October of the year. The peak tourist season here begins in June and runs through October. Running parallel to the beach coastline is a sandy pedestrian footpath known as the beachfront path. It stretches for about 1.25 miles on White Beach and helps to separate the beach itself from the establishments and vendors that are located along the path. For thrill seekers, they have a reverse bungee ride located on the beachfront path. It accommodates up to 3 people at a time and always draws a crowd at every session that enjoy the adrenaline-pumping show of screaming daredevils.
Near the northwest side of the island, you can find more amazing views of Boracay, exposing the volcanic origins of the island.
This formation rests 150 feet offshore in shallow water. It's a castle-like volcanic landmark, natural rock formation overshadowing White Beach's landscape and directly in front of Willie's Beach Resort. There are steps leading up to a small chapel on top with a statue of the Virgin Mary. The local community was very passionate about the religion during the time it was built.
Here we are at Barangay Beach. It's a very secluded area. It's located right above Dinuit Beach.
This beach is even more private and secluded away from the tourist areas. Nestled on a hillside, it's a place more situated for travelers occupying lodging within this area. After wearing ourselves out exploring the island's western coastline, we head back to White Beach's centrally located mall and shopping area. From the main island road, we hop on a motorized tricycle cab. There are a ton of these on the island, and a shared fare is extremely inexpensive compared to a dedicated private driver, which costs a bit more. The ride lasts about 15 minutes before we pull up to the street entrance of the outdoor mall complex.
The mall is the main shopping area on the island.
When the sun sets in Boracay, it's a spectacular event not to be missed. It is also the time when all the sailboats are dispersed into the horizon. The evening draws the crowds back to the White Beach path for the outdoor fine dining. And passers-by are drawn into bars and restaurants by the hypnotic musical concerts and displays. Establishments reward the visitors with a free dance show displayed nightly on the walking path. Next day, we continue the adventure on the island's eastern coastline, exploring all the best beaches and activities beginning from the southern point of Bulabog Beach.
The Boracay Rock is on the east side near the lower end of the island.
Visitors here line up at the kiteboarding, windsurfing, and parasailing ticket stations. It doesn't seem to be an ideal beach for swimming. It is more suitable for water sports due to the high amount of wind. Protecting the huge bay is an offshore reef producing superb flat to choppy water conditions on the inside of the bay. Past the next rock peninsula, we finally arrive at the private beach resort and famous Gateway Arch, natural rock formation located on the tip of Lapu's Beach.
Gateway Arch is on the east side featuring spectacular views of Lapu's Beach and the northern coastline.
This huge landmark doorway exposing the southern side to Bulabog Beach is a worthwhile visit, especially for photography enthusiasts. This is another peaceful location about 1.5 miles away.
Here at Puka Beach, it's located in the undeveloped far north end of the island. This is the second largest beach without the large crowds and vendors.
I hope you have enjoyed this adventure as much as I did. Please join us again next time as we conquer and explore more amazing destinations.